Ohio's 1,000-mile network of canals opened distant markets for our agricultural products and attracted thousands of immigrants. The canals were our first transportation system.
In the 1820s, Ohio was an isolated wilderness, a poor frontier state. But that was about to change. In 1825, Ohio started moving toward the future at 4 miles an hour. We're at Roscoe Village near Coshocton to learn how canals changed Ohio. First, we have to understand just how different things were back then.
Most of the freight in the 1820s was carried by Conestoga wagons. The roads of the day were impassable quagmires during the early spring and summer of the year, and bone-jarring, axle-breaking obstacle courses the rest.
Ohio needed a transportation system, and Ohio chose canals as the way to move the state into the future. Construction began in Heath, Ohio on July 4th, 1825.
Ohio's canals were built mostly with muscle power from humans, from oxen, and from horses. There's talk of them using scoops and rails and ox power to bring things up out of deep cuts, but it was mostly wheelbarrows, picks and shovels, and men.
It was excruciating labor, often in difficult conditions. But when they were done, the workers constructed about 1,000 miles of canals, including 294 lift locks to raise and lower the canal boats. The work was completed by 1847. Denny Blanford is a volunteer on the Monticello 3 at Roscoe Village.
Now I'm your captain today. My name is Denny.
Denny and the other boat captains bring the history of the canals to life.
We had two main arteries. We had the Ohio Erie, which is this right here, connected the Ohio River to Lake Erie. And then we had the other main artery called the Miami Erie, from Cincinnati to Toledo. But we had many smaller canals feeding into these main arteries.
Three different types of boats traveled the canals.
We had the packet, which is what this boat is, the Monticello 3 here at Roscoe Village. And packet, in layman terms, would be a passenger canal boat. We also had something called a freight canal boat, cargo canal boat. And then we had a combination packet and cargo.
A freighter would get about a mile, mile and a half an hour, not very fast. You didn't get much speed from canals. What you got was tonnage and fewer horses to pull things. For instance, a freight wagon could carry only a ton, maybe 2 tons, and take 6 horses and 4 or 5 men. A canal boat with just 2 horses could carry 50, 60 tons.
Soon, canal boats were improved, and some carried over 85 tons of cargo. For a comparison, a modern semi can also haul 85 tons. So canal boats were the big rigs of the mid-1800s. Everyone benefited from the canals, but Ohio's farmers gained the most.
Prior to the opening of the canal, wheat would sell for 25 cents a bushel. After the canal was opened, even partially, the price of wheat rose to 75 cents a bushel, then a dollar, and finally a dollar and a quarter.
Ohio corn, wheat, and hogs were suddenly available and in demand in all the big eastern markets. Farming became a profitable business. And all along the canals, small towns sprang up. Many prospered. But rails were already being laid across the state. And as the railroads replaced the canals, these small canal towns slowly faded from the map.
Roscoe Village sort of died after the canal era. The railroad came, and the railroad came to Coshocton across the river. So Roscoe Village just declined.
But Roscoe Village has come back to life. Walk through the historic village, and you can hear the clanging of the blacksmith's hammer and the buzz of commerce.
The buildings have been preserved so well that it's just like stepping back in history.
period craftspeople show visitors what life was like in a prosperous Ohio canal town in the 1800s.
Roscoe Village is a unique institution. They have kept not only the structures, but they've kept the information and the photographs of the era, and it's they've done a wonderful, wonderful job that otherwise might have been lost.
Ride the Monticello 3. Listen to the stories told by the boat captain, and you'll learn a lot about the Ohio Canal era.
The boats were mandated by the state to travel no faster than 4 miles per hour. And the reasoning was they didn't want to wash away the clay banks holding in the water. Horses and mules were used to pull the boat. They would generally work around 12 to 15 miles, and then they would stop, and then we'd have a fresh team right here in the middle of the boat, and we'd unload them and hook them up.
Gliding peacefully on the canal on a warm summer's day, and it's easy to form an idealized view of the canal era. Reality was sometimes very different. When two boats approached a lock from opposite directions, it was not uncommon for the captains to get into a fistfight to see which boat would proceed through the locks first.
It wasn't all serene. It was a rough time. I mean, these folks were rough. And the rougher reputation you had, the quicker you got through somewhere. So there was lots of commotion going on. I'm not sure if it was all happy at times, but it was interesting.
Ohio's canal era didn't last for long, but the canals moved Ohio a long way from an isolated wilderness toward a prosperous future.